This is the device which monitors, records temperature and humidity and gives phone call and SMS alert to 8 operators if the temperature or humidity goes above or below the programmed limits for a certain duration. You can view the readings on the device, on your local PC or over the internet. This is the temperature graph you will see on your web browser. You can see that there are 2 readings corresponding to 2 sensors per device. In this case, both are temperature sensors. Also, we can have 1 temperature sensor and 1 humidity sensor. This is an installation done inside a chiller room. There are 2 sensors inside this chiller room. This is the first sensor on one corner of the room. This is the second sensor in another corner of the room. This is the box fitted outside the chiller room which contains the data logger. This is the data logger inside the box. You can see that both the sensors are showing the reading alternately. These sensors on the left side are the ones going inside the chiller room. Here you can see the graph once again. Now if the temperature goes above or below the programmed limits for a programmed delay, it will give phone call and SMS alert to 8 operators. Here the call is coming. Upon attending the call, it will give a customized voice message. After listening to the voice message, the operator has to press the hash sign button to acknowledge the alert. If the first person does not attend the call or does not press the hash button, or if his phone is busy, the call will go to the second person and so on. In this case, I would like to show you without pressing the hash button. I have just disconnected the call without pressing the hash sign button. For demonstration, only 1 mobile number is programmed and hence the call will come back to the same number. Here comes the call. For every person who does not attend the call or does not acknowledge the call, an SMS message will be received indicating location and type of the alert. Now I have acknowledged by pressing the hash button and hence the call has stopped. If the problem is not rectified within a certain duration, say 10 minutes, the call will repeat once again. This delay duration can be programmed. The entire system has a battery backup and will work for a couple of days without main power. Also, you will receive an SMS message as soon as main power is lost. The device operates with a prepaid or postpaid SIM card and hence no phone lines are required. Now we will see various setting parameters. In this screen you can see the device identification parameters such as name for the device, IP address assigned for the device, etc. You can name the device which will be displayed on top of your graph and reports. Also, you can set the frequency in which the data is collected from the device to the computer. In this case, you can see that the data is collected every 2 minutes. In the second screen, you can see various settings related to sending of email alerts and online storage of the readings. Also, the alert messages can be sent to 4 email ads which can be programmed in this screen. In this case, you can see the warning email is sent from an email ID provided by us, so that we can also frequently check the sent box to see the alerts generated. You can also select the option to send the current readings through email at certain intervals. In this example, this option is turned off. Also, you can select the actions to be taken when alert events occur. In this case, you can see that emails will be generated and also the dry contact will be closed, which is used to generate phone call and SMS alerts. In this third screen, you can see the settings for generating alerts. Also, the subject and content of the email alert messages can be defined here. In this screen, you can define the upper and lower limits of the temperature and the delay after which the alert should be generated. In this particular example, it can be seen that only upper alert limit is set at a temperature of minus 10 degrees centigrade and the delay time is 30 minutes. Hence, an alert will be generated if the temperature goes above minus 10 degree for a duration of 30 minutes. Also, you can set the auto sending of recorded data. In this case, it is programmed that the data will be sent every day at 12:00 AM. This is the last screen in which the clock settings and recording settings are programmed. In this example, the recording is done every 10 seconds. Also, the general system parameters are shown in this screen. Thus, you can see that the programming of the device is very simple and user-friendly. We also have a separate slideshow indicating the detailed programming of the device.